Right. So today we were going to speak about a very important part of called rasayana, because like everywhere you would be hearing about you improving your immune and all that, no? Like because at the time of this COVID season, people who had problems of even when they are affected or COVID positive also, some people were able to manage. That was because our immune response, if it is at a certain degree, then we'll be able to manage any circumstance or any any microbial attack or anything that comes, because our antibodies will be ready to attack it. And that will be possible only because our body has to be fit enough. And even when you're considering it that fit enough, you have to make sure that many of the things are to be rightly considered in your body regularly also. As I told you, the yoga, the vyayama, or the dinacharya, these are all measures to keep your body at bay from creating the diseases. Because I'm taking this example of COVID because it is the timely of time of the hour to discuss things also. COVID has mostly symptoms which are related to the upper respiratory tract. And can you imagine that when I was telling all this dinacharya, it was always materials that was above the clavicle only has to be removed. So that is why the dinacharya, if you are following the routine of that itself, you are trying to create a pattern wherein you're preventing most of the problems. You're preventing an accumulation of the doshas in your body. You're preventing your turbidity. Like, you know, there can be like based on the environmental conditions and all, your body can accumulate some dirt and all that. So you're trying to eliminate it externally also, physically, I should say, physically or externally from your outside part of the body. And then you're trying to keep yourself internally also very pure and clean. So what happens is there is no accumulation of any material which is going to create that slogginess in you, or it is going to create any disease in you. But if at all you feel that there is a demand of the body that it needs a certain thing to help support it, that is actually called as rasayana. Actually speaking, if you come consider some years back, there was some pattern of procedures in our daily life itself. Like our mothers used to give this ghee just before you go to school, no? Just giving them a half spoon of ghee. It was a regular pattern. Drinking of milk, we don't have any doubt about it. It is like you have to take whether you like it or not. So these are all patterns which was a regular sign. Intaking of nuts in a very few quantity, but regularly. That is also a rasayana. So these were all considered as a rasayana only to improve the rasa. It is actually the rasa that we are trying to improve. And when rasa is improved itself, what happens is all the subsequent dhatus get the best nourishment, and the ojas is at its strongest. And what it is like, you're undergoing seven stages of the same digestion of the material, and the end product which comes out of it is the ojas, which is at its purest form. And when you're having the best rasa, that rasa itself, rasa, you can compare it to the intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid, or the actual chyle that has been developed from the food material after it undergoes a proper digestion. So that quantity of food, when it is actually going to each cell of the body, what happens is you are completely trying to create a pattern wherein getting affected from disease itself becomes a question mark. You will not get affected by any disease. And there is a condition of pattern that is regularly happening in the body. So you tried like some period of time, you know, the Dabur Chyawanprash, it came like many advertisements started, and after that only really you can see many homes that Chyawanprash was there. And Chyawanprash was also taken as a regular diet. So what happens is like the people who were using it regularly started getting affected by diseases less. So that is the different pattern. So people who are very commonly prone to some condition, like they can get affected, when we try to create a pattern and customizing some materials to them which they can use regularly, and at the same time we're not going to increase the doshas or decrease the doshas, but to moderate the doshas, and that dosha moderation will actually help in keeping at the bay the diseases getting affected. So here we'll go on to the slide. Rasayana is one of the comprehensive discipline of Ayurveda, which comprises herbs. Usage of herbs is one way. Herbo-mineral formulations. I was telling about this Chyavanaprasha. That is actually a herbo-mineral formulation. Food articles. Food articles can be like when you're talking about milk, ghee, all that. And then lifestyle along with self-discipline. Like, let me tell you, in Ayurveda, when we were talking about this Dinacharya itself, there was one part of the chapter itself which talked only about the conduct. That is called as Achara Rasayana. I will talk about in detail also. Achara Rasayana was actually meant only for disciplining yourself. What are you going to do with yourself and in disciplining? So that was related to how they behaved with the people in a social manner, and that was actually related to their mental status and all that. So lifestyle along with discipline, self-etiquette and social etiquette, all this was connected with the mental attitude also, and this will be related to achieve the optimum. So all of these together only are going to work on improving the tissues and the system of the body. So that we know that there is a COVID situation and we have to use masks, but people wantedly don't use masks. So that itself is an etiquette of not following the social importance of wearing a mask. So that is actually the social crisis, like in cases of especially this spreading communicable type of diseases and all, you have to actually follow some rules. So that is actually only can be happening when we have a self-discipline. And next is the Rasayana is a way to achieve homeostasis. Homeostasis means here it is like a balance. We are not trying to keep you that you are not going to get disease at all. That you cannot say, because there are so many situations that can help you or make you available for so many diseases also. But even when you are getting exposed to such circumstances, even at that condition when you are not getting disease, that means your body is actually in having the proper rasayana, and that is actually important. And actually speaking, anti-aging and all that has been explained, but the anti-aging is actually in that the cells are actually getting re-energized or reactivated or regenerated, and thus prevention of diseases also happen. So here you can see that rasayana, what are different types. So based on the rasayana benefit, they are actually mentioned as kamya rasayana. Kamya rasayana means we are intending to have some rasayana. We are interested in that, and so we are having that, which actually using of this Chyavanaprasha itself can be kamya rasayana. Naimittika rasayana means naimittika rasayana is intended for a disease better, because you have a disease. Once you cure the disease, there is a stage wherein you need a rasayana. Like for example, cancer. Cancer, actually, there is a medicine called Ballataka that can be used, Chitraka that can be used as a rasayana therapy, so that you don't have a spread of it. You don't have a condition wherein the disease can occur again. So that is actually rasayana for specific diseases. Based on the method of use, Vata Atapika, it is called Vata Atapika. Vata Atapika means you're getting exposed to all type of circumstances, and in that condition also you can use the medicine, which will help in improving your immune levels. That is actually called as Vata Atapika Rasayana. Here also I take the example of Chyavanaprasha, because that's a medicine we can use it at any time. That is not restricted. There is no restriction as such. But that is also the Chyavanaprasha is a medicine which can be used with restriction also. But generally when you speak, it can be used as a common thing also. Kuti Praveshika Rasayana. Kuti Praveshika Rasayana is the actual rasayana treatment mentioned in as per Ayurveda. Kuti Praveshika means, kuti itself means there is a house, and Praveshika means you're entering. you're entering a house which is in which is actually built for the purpose, sole purpose of having a rasayana. And I'll talk in detail. Achara rasayana is actually the good conduct, or it's a disciplined form of life. And then based on the material used, it can be varied to aushadha rasayana. Aushadha rasayana means you're using materials as such. You're using drugs. You're using actually some, like for example, to improve the intellect. You're using the Centella Asiatica, which is actually like, we call this Manduka Parni. You use as Vallare and all that. It's actually, there is a green leafy vegetable. It can also be used as vegetable, but mostly it is used like a medicine. And Ajastika Rasayana is diet-based. Here, we talk about the milk, honey, ghee and all that, which can be used as an Ajastika Rasayana. Based on like diet, some medicines, some can be used as diet and some can be used as more than medicines. So this is Ajastika Rasayana or the Kamya Rasayana, which forms the usage of materials that we use in our daily routine. Yeah, that can actually increase our physical body. The immune system of our body can be actually improved by the usage of these materials. As I already told you about honey. Honey is one material which is actually keeping at bay the vata and pitta conditions. And it also improves your digestive pattern. It is a very good material to improve your healing properties in the body. And so what happens is like, it works like an alkaline also. So it's not very acidic in nature. So you can use one teaspoon. Even with normal water, it is actually going to help you. Only thing that it should not be heated, because when it becomes heated, it becomes like a poison as per Ayurveda. And research also proves so. It becomes like, I don't know if I've already told, there is an aldehyde that gets formed when you heat the honey. And so it is advised that honey should not be heated in any form. Then milk. Milk is actually a material which is sweet in taste, and at the end of digestion also it becomes sweet. So what happens is it is very conducive to the body, because the body is always considered as something which is very sweet in nature for everyone. Sweet in nature, and it should have some snigdha properties, some unctuousness should be there, and that is also there in the milk. And the third one, that is it should be cold in potency. If it becomes hot in potency, the body always have a tendency to catch up infections. So it should be in a normal temperature mode. So that means it is more towards a colder nature than towards a hotter nature. So milk is one thing which is actually cold, so which actually helps. So that's why we add a little bit of turmeric or pepper or something like that. If you add, it will balance up the coldness of the milk, which will actually help with giving that anushna nature. It is not that hot, it is not that cold. And then the ghee. Ghee is one thing which actually keeps that temperature of the body, and then it is sweet after when you taste, and after the end of digestion also it is sweet. So all of these turn us becoming rasayanas also, which will help in improving the consistency of the material to be transformed in a way that is absorbed by the body and nothing will stay. So all of these are very important, as the ghee itself has a intracellular pathway. It can go to each cell and nourish it. So that is why the ghee is one of the best medicines that can be given just as a diet at home itself. You can see that nourishing suitable healthy food, that is actually the main key idea. It can include any food. Speaking, even the red rice is considered as a rasayana, but you cannot take too much of quantity. It has to be restricted. And just like that, all of these materials have to be given in a restricted material, but at the same time, the properties of it can improve the, if it improves the health of the body, then it is considered as a rasayana. It is called Ajastrika Rasayana. And then comes Naimittika Rasayana. Here it is actually Aushadha, where you are going to use some medicines which will be targeting the disease as such, or the, when a patient comes to you, the medicine, when you're giving us a Naimittika Rasayana or Aushadha Rasayana, it should target the patient. The prakriti of the patient should be analyzed, and based on that only we'll be giving the medicine. Along with that, the disease, the stage of the disease is to be understood. And then the third comes the circumstance he is in, which place he lives based on that. Rasayana, when we said Chyawanprash, it will not be given to people who are in very cold climate, because it has got more of amla. It can actually increase kapha also. So you have to give it in a way that it can add it up with another lehi also. So what happens is it will balance the dosha under the climate circumstance also. When it is a very hot climate, you are not advised to give some ashwagandha di lehi and all that. So what happens is you have to add it with a little bit of other medicines which will help in balancing it. Now, it is not only that we are giving only the drugs which are actually plant material, it is actually minerals also that will be given. For example, mercury is considered as one of the best rasayana, which will always be given along with the combination. Mercury will always be given with the combination of sulfur, because when mercury and sulfur combines, the combination becomes in a such that it can be made it into a powder, and that powder can be assimilated by the body, it can be absorbed by the body. And once it is turned into ash, then it will be perfect as a rasayana. Now you can see the first one was Guduchi and Amlaki. The one with the heart-shaped leaf, no? It's actually called Guduchi. And it's a very wonderful plant. It's called Tinospora cordifolia. We call it Giloy in Hindi. This is one of the plants that has been used for many, many diseases. And even in case of COVID, it was actually acting. There were researchers which actually proved that it could be very effective. And Amalaki is one of the rasayanas that can be taken regularly by a person also. For case of diabetes, if you're taking daily an amlaki itself, it will help cure the diabetes. Even at least even if you're not able to cure the problem, you'll be able to put it under control for people who are having very bad kind of wavering type of variance in the sugar levels. Then Ashwagandha, Guduchi and Pipali. Now Ashwagandha is a medicine. Vidhanya somnifera is a medicine which has been effective even in cancers. And then Guduchi, Pipali. Pipali is one of medicine which is used as a rasayana. It's a serious rasayana itself. It is used for liver problems, bronchial problems, any kind of breathing disorders, allergies and all that. And then comes Centella. You can see the kind of bean-shaped, kidney-shaped leaves, no? It is actually Centella asiatica, the green leaf. This will be actually used as vegetable also. In Tamil Nadu, I have seen this has been taken like a chutney, they use it. And apart from that, you have many tablets also in this. This is a very serious medicine, which is used in many demyelinating conditions, degenerative conditions of the brain, glioma type of conditions and all that. Here, Medhya Rasayana. Medhya Rasayana means anything that improves the intellect. Like there is one medicine called Brahma Rasayana. Brahma Rasayana is a medicine combination just like Chyawanaprasha that has actually been studied for in patients who are aged to improve the memory and intellect. So, Vatatatika Rasayana, just as I told, people who are regularly going to office and who are getting exposed to many circumstances, just to keep the diseases at bay, they can take some medicine. And this is like one medicine that can be intaken regularly, Chyawanaprash. There is not a restriction, but it is helpful for improving their own immunity. This is the Kuti Praveshik. As I told you, this is a very rare treatment that has been done. And I should say, I should become Vachala because this is one of the therapies wherein you can bring back your youth, I should say. One of the person who underwent, selection criteria for this actually goes that the person should not have any self-interest. The person should be actually trying to get back to his youth only for social commitment purpose. So many selection criteria are there once you have to select a person for this rasayana therapy. And the person actually, what happens is when they check for all the blood parameters, all the arterioles and all that, they could identify that. The thing is that you can see in the black and white picture, there is one inner square. In the inner square, only the patient will be there, and the walls will be built in a way that the sunlight doesn't penetrate. It will be only for air purpose that the ventilation is kept, and no air will penetrate. So no light will penetrate. So it will be almost like the person is completely in dark. It's almost like comparing the same therapy of putting them into the womb. How we regrow, how we were growing up, just like that, we are giving the patient a chance again to regrow. So they actually, it is mentioned that they shed their nails and all that, but actually speaking, the nails grow in a way that it is like a baby nail. And the arterioles and all that, it has been understood that the aging process is completely reversed. So there are so much of studies also which showed that this Rasayana really works. But the patient have to be really patient, because almost for 48 days to 50 days, the patient has to be inside this. Prior to that, they have to undergo all the panchakarmas. All the panchakarmas means it will take almost 2 months for all the panchakarmas to be undergone, and then only they undergo all this Rasayana therapy. So it's like a big process, but let me tell you, like, each of the cell will get re-energized. Next is Achara Rasayana. I put this picture on purpose because nowadays we see that so many old age homes are coming up. But until 10 years back, at least I think there was not much of these old age homes because of the joint family tree and all that we had. Now that we're going to nuclear families, we don't have people to look for. So the thing is that ultimately the children don't have a chance to learn how to respect elders. So when there was people who were there in our families to take care, automatically the children knew also how to respect, how to take care of them. So then there was this cows and all. So getting their blessings, puja done for them, and then intaking food in a very solemn manner, do not speak while there. So these are all some of the disciplines that have been mentioned for a person to lead a normal life. It is not that they are going to have a very harmonious life and all that. It's like for a normal person to undergo a normal life, only some things have been mentioned. So these can actually be, it's almost like 20 to 23 things are mentioned. I just quoted some, that's it. It is like some of the righteous things that you have to do in your life. And those, what happens is, there has been research which proves that once you do gratitude itself, like you are doing something to a person itself, there has been a study which showed the person's ability to respond to treatment actually improved. And they did it on patients who were undergoing this chemotherapy. So what happened was, every time the patient came for a chemotherapy, they gave him some toy or something to give it to some person, and they would see the happiness that they get when the person who is getting it responds. So that was actually viewed upon, and then they go for the chemotherapy. So after that, the improvement that they saw was tremendous. So that gratitude or thanksgiving is very important. So this is actually like a part of Rasayana which works with the psychological side. Now, physical side I've already told you. Now, coming back to this Rasayana, understanding Rasayana is mainly important because in this prison scenario, all of you would be thinking that you have to have this ginger and all that, which are actually depleting in nature also. So you have to analyze which are actually good for improving your health also. And then you have to make sure that that is being done regularly rather than using medicine which will help depleting some things. So that's all I end for today's session. We'll look into the questions.
I think we will take more of questions now as we are ending today.
If there are questions which have been pertaining to other topics also, we can have, because Rasayana, if it is little,
on hold, that's right.
On the whole, I'm available until 7 o'clock.
We need to have a recording of the, all the five sessions. How can we get that?
Yes, we have already recorded that, and I think Ananta Mind Studio will be uploading from Monday onwards. And so is Bharati Vidyavan's Center for Indology also. So you can avail about the site. You can go through it. Anyone has questions?
Yeah, ma'am, can I? Yes, I do.
Please.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask. Yeah, I wanted to ask, ma'am, why is milk become such a villain in today's time? I mean, we've grown up having milk, but nowadays there's so much said about milk is not good, you cannot digest it. Please clarify this for me.
So actually, there are more people who are going vegan also. That is also one of the criteria, I should say.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, there are some attributes that has been mentioned for milk, especially cow's milk. That is what I was telling. And we used to get from the grazing cows until some period of time. Now that we have all these cattle, we have all these cows and all, which have been tightly packed and then in sheds, which have been grown only, which have been actually fed too much of material, which is actually like bulking up the cow just for the purpose of milking it. So what happens is, the quality of the material has surely depleted. But the problem is, we don't have such a great shift of material. So at least a little bit of milk has to go to our body. We don't have any other choice.
Okay. So there's no problem of digestion. Even, now we are all dependent on the milk that we get from, the various dairies.
So I feel that it is based on the quantity that you take. That's why I always advise, first you start with half glass of milk and check after how many minutes or how many hours are you getting this digestion completed. Like you will feel, after you take something, you feel your hunger pangs after some period. Then it actually means that you're able to digest completely. But if you feel that after you take, you're feeling that fullness, then it means that you have to boil your milk with a little bit of dry ginger or add with a little bit of turmeric or something like that.
So that helps in the digestion?
Yes. Okay. It helps in digestion, improving your digestion at a quicker pace.
Okay. Thank you so much.
There are a number of peppercorns to the milk while boiling for a better digestion and to also take care of the seasonal cough and cold. I don't get any seasonal cough, cold, fever at all. I think I give credit to the milk that I boil with, a certain number of peppercorns. So I think, is this good? And what is this? You just tell me the...
It can be completely taken like that. That's not a problem. When we ask them to add turmeric or pepper, it's like this turmeric latte and all. Now it's famous, right? Turmeric latte, yellow milk and all that. So it can be taken either that you're adding these spices to hot milk or you can even boil. That's not a problem.
Alright.
It will be good.
The curd and curd also is good with along with the pepper. So this is what preferably is done.
I want to ask a larger question, if you permit.
Is it okay to put black cardamom, because that's what our granny used to put?
Yeah, black cardamom is also good. Yeah, cardamom is also good because cardamom is also against this vata and kapha. Yeah, it is also acting against. Actually, we all consider this ela or the cardamom to be very cold in nature. Let me tell you, it's the opposite. It's actually hot.
Big cardamom. My granny would always put that while boiling the milk.
Yes.
Wonderful.
It has the same properties.
But they said turmeric is not soluble in milk. So is it better to have in water or milk?
That's if you're intending to take the turmeric as such, I think it will be better if you add it with honey and take, or you water. But if you're intending that you need only the essence of the turmeric to go to the milk, I don't think you have to add turmeric as such into milk.
So it is better to have in water, right? So that's what.
Yes, water or honey. Honey will also be a better choice.
Oh, excellent. Thank you.
Actually, if you have the best honey, it will be really good, you know, because the honey, which is actually good in the best quality, it will have not just the sweet taste, it will have an astringent taste.
Yes.
Of late, actually, I've been traveling to Karnataka, and I got a bottle of honey. I should say it's bliss. When you take it, you really feel the difference, because that honey, once you take the honey with the normal water itself, what happens is that you feel that throat is getting cleared immediately. Just honey and water, that itself is giving such difference. So how good it will be, like, if you are adding with medicines.
Right. Is that a Coorg honey, Dr. Aranya?
Pardon?
Is it a Coorgi honey?
It's I got it from Coorg. Yeah, I got it actually from Coorg. Let me tell you, there is, I just saw a video in YouTube probably, in which actually, just like how the water, we understand that it will be able to bring back memories, right? There is a condition that we say that the water has a capability to bring back the memory. So it will store up whatever has the stored up memories, it can reciprocate. So what we do is, in water, we add a drop of honey, and then if you just rotate, that honeycomb pattern will come up. Trust me, it doesn't come in all of these propagated honey. I have never seen that come.
I agree with you. I agree with you totally.
So if you're going to any of these, please do not look for the price. Price doesn't matter. You will be giving heavy prices, but you are not going to get the real honey.
So where do we get the real honey?
You have to go for the forest, you know, like any people who is related with some forest, only you will be able to collect the real honey.
Right. From the
Khadi Gramodyog, they will get you a real good honey.
Where is that?
Khadi Gramodyog Commission.
Yes, Khadi.
Gramodyog Commission, you get a real good honey from Kashmir. Okay, okay. I have four or five type of honey, but Kashmir one is the real wonderful.
Okay.
Or even the tribal welfare board. Tribal welfare board also sells.
Yes, that's true. With the tribal also we can get. Yeah. Next question, please.
Larger question to ask if you permit. If you have time, maybe you can answer it a little later at the last session. What I'm saying is,
no, that's okay, sir. You can go ahead and ask questions.
In Kerala or Tamil Nadu, in South India, Ayurveda is still alive. How come in North India, I don't find anything in Banaras, I don't find anything here? We have some school called Samalakha and all that. But how come people have very little respect for those kind of institutions here in North India? What is the reason?
Actually speaking, just because by practice only, it is not that intentional, but by practice, there's a disturbance.
It's fine. There is some disturbance mobile for very many.
Okay. Actually speaking, it is only by practice, and I should say, like, there might be some difference of opinion also. Like, it is my opinion that everyone are practicing Ayurveda being given a chance. In North and all, it is not much of propagated. So that is why they have to go for allopathic practice also. But generally, if there is a chance, because I have seen many people in my career also, like, many people who are practicing well in North also. So it's not that they would not practice. It is not that. It is only that they are not given that proper right.
There is a huge difference between the Ayurveda, which is widely practiced in South of India, especially in Kerala, and the North of India. There is a huge difference. Trust me, I have seen both the sides. So there is a difference.
Exactly.
So,
like,
I'm
must be the
questions for later.
The Kerala tradition shifting to South India, probably. That is why. Yes. No, there was an Ashtavaidya parampara that was there in Kerala. The traditions of curing was there for the Ashta families, and so that they may probably would have taken up through all the course of South India. But let me tell you, in North also there are so many people who are there for practicing really worthy. But maybe the change in material that they use will be there for sure. It's not sure that everywhere the plant material itself is being used. In North, actually, the minerals are most used. So that is fine.
Okay.
Ma'am, can I ask you a question?
About Manuka honey. What about Manuka honey? And also, kindly, if you can list out all the honeys that you mentioned and where to get it from, please.
Actually, I'm not able to remember all the 8 types of honey. But in that, I can remember the best thing is that it's called Brahmari. That is actually the very small type of honey, honey bee, that is actually the best considered among the 8 varieties.
Okay. Ma'am, can I ask
and what about Manuka honey?
I think it's a specific flower or so.
It's actually come from New Zealand, and that's called Manuka honey. They said it's very good for digestion as well.
Okay. You know, like, let me tell you, like, there are honey based on different regions, like, you know, some specific flowers they keep nearby, so that the benefit of that flowers are also being attracted by that honey. So we get the benefit of that flowers. That is why I asked you if it is like something like Manuka honey. I'm not sure about it.
Okay, we have a question from Sapna.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Actually, I want to ask you that regarding amla, if I take amla, I have a lot of acidity already. So taking raw amla, how can I take amla? In which form? Can I mix it with honey or what is the best way?
When you take amla, you have acidity?
Yes, ma'am.
Then somewhere probably you're going wrong.
Is it?
You can do one thing. You can soak a little bit of, means like 1 or 2 amlas you can take. Soak it in warm water the previous night. The next day morning you try in taking it.
Taking only the water or
The water. You just actually have to crush it. You just have to grind the whole thing and then take only the water.
Okay.
And once you're okay, you can take the whole thing also.
Okay, fine, ma'am. And can we mix amla with honey also?
It is not necessary because, like as I told you, some things have, it is better to take as such. Do not mix anything whenever it's not necessary.
I nahi bolo this bone saath
khaungi. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
There's a kaide sticker.
Okay, so question with the amla itself. You have mentioned about the amla juice, you know, if somebody even with the diabetic, if they can take. What is the quantity that you prescribe to generally help?
The best usage would be maximum 2 to 3.
Dr. Shishi Balaji, can you mute Kalpesh ji?
Okay. Actually, the amlaki that you're taking when it is fresh, it is better to use maximum of 2 to 3. That would be enough. Because, you know, I have seen personally, the tiredness of the patient will be actually reduced when you are using this amlaki. Because when you have a person with diabetes, that's the first thing you note. They have always, they are tired. That's because they are lacking in that nutrition element.
Pardon? The best time to have amla for a normal healthy person.
It can be any time during the day. If you have one amla a day, it's actually almost like an apple a day keeps the doctor away. It's just like that. It is actually mentioned as Karaprachitiyam Rasayana. We have actually one chapter which mentioned that Karaprachitiyam, like you can pluck a amlaki and intake daily. That is very healthy. So one amlaki a day is like you are giving a daily dose of your daily dose of Rasayana to your body.
Right.
If amla is not available, can we have dry amla powder also?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
It has the same benefit.
Yes, yes, it has the same benefit.
Okay.
What about all the amla juices available in the market?
No, a strict no. It has more sugar than the amla.
No, not those. The ones, this Ramdev Babas and so many which are pure amla juice, are they claiming?
Let me tell you, you will, you know, actually when you are using either the fresh form or the dry form, you are not adding anything that is not required by the body. So that would be the best. Because when once you're processing it, you are adding material which are not good for the body also. Unknowingly or knowingly. So because when you're saying it as a syrup, surely you will have the preservative. Mostly the sugar base is actually a preservative.
So let's try is now. Amla ki different from amla?
Pardon?
Is amla ki different from amla?
No, it's the same. It's actually the Ayurvedic term. That's it. The Sanskrit name. That's it.
And what about murabba, like we used to have as children, which was preserved in sugar juice, sugar syrup?
That's not a problem because, like, once a while, I was like, you know, if you are trying to make it, try making it in honey. That will be the best. Otherwise, it's just for children and all, it's not a problem. At least they're having it in that form.
So, no, that was the way of preserving because in every season one didn't get amla. So, when in season one would make a murabba. Otherwise, yeah. Can we have it just raw?
Yeah, that's best.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll ask you a question because yesterday, last 2 days, 3 days, I've been getting a lot of mails and, you know, WhatsApp messages on this. I just wanted to put it in a different way. Potatoes are largely consumed, you know, all over India, especially in north of India. Potatoes are consumed like almost every day and every dish. So there are a lot of issues arises, you know, people who are suffering from different diseases. You know, I don't want to mention what are all they.
Starting from diabetes, cholesterol to everything.
Yes. So I just wanted you to throw a little light. What can be the best alternative, you know, in people who are so obsessed with eating potatoes most of the times, especially everything and anything. And secondly, if there is also a kind of a craving that I've seen with the potatoes with a lot of people, what is the best alternative for them?
Actually, it would be the best to try avoiding after a certain period of age, you know, like after a age group only mostly that creates a problem, like 30 years or so, it mostly starts creating problem. Until then, it doesn't create much of a problem. But if you are actually trying to intaking it, you have to intake it with mostly this, any of these digestives like ajwain, this ajamoda we call in Ayurveda. This is one of the medicines which will help reducing that bloating tendency. So what happens is kind of bloating condition, distension will not be there. And it will be properly digested also. But at the same time, if you are trying to include more of this potatoes itself, it can improve the quantity of starch that you're taking where the body will be increased. So I don't think that is a healthy one. Even if it is traditionally followed also, you can use other patterns like using palak and all will not be a good problem. But the aloo regularly will actually create problem in the long run.
Okay, all right. So any alternative that you suggest for people who are craving potato?
It is not that you should not take at all. It is only that you can create like a pattern wherein you have it once or twice a week. That will be good.
Ma'am, log upvas mein sabudana khate hain. Sabudana mein kitna starch hota hai?
No, actually, I'm telling that when you're intaking starch directly, it is required only by certain quantity. Like if you're taking rice itself, that is a starch. But that is also regulated. It's carbohydrate only, that's regulated. But when you're taking as a vegetable, you can supplement with other vegetables and this a little bit so that it will not create harm. You know, in as per traditional cooking, no, we have this avial. We call it avial. In that, we have so many vegetables added in it. So what happens is it actually complements with each other, which wherein there is no problems arising by either of them. So you can try that vegetable, mixed vegetable cooking. That will be a better option.
I was asking, madam, sabudana in North India, sabudana people take during the fasting, but sabudana is nothing but the full of starch.
Okay.
I want your comments. How good is this practice of taking sabudana?
Actually, sabudana is not a problem because it's one of the medicine. It's actually very good in the digestive problems, you know, like if you have diarrhea and all that. But as you said, it is the material that is starch. That is why we use it. So how when you use it is very important. You're not supposed to use too much quantity also.
And a lot of people use the sabudana again with aloo.
Yeah. Okay.
So
I think that you don't have to make it very frequent. That's it. If it is not very frequent, it's not going to create a problem.
Once in a week, on to all Tuesdays.
Yeah. Yes.
At least for me.
Ma'am, are there any rasayanas you'd like to suggest for senior citizens that they can take on dinacharya? Any rasayanas that you can suggest which they can take on dinacharya? Like you suggested amlaki?
Yeah. Brahma rasayana is a medicine. You can go check for Brahma rasayana, which is a wonderful medicine, because you know, like as age goes by, people generally have this forgetfulness and memory problems and intellect connection, you know, like you find it difficult to connect to people and all that, no? So all these issues can be actually targeted when you use this Brahma rasayana. It's a very good medicine. So just one teaspoon of it can be regularly intake.
What about chavala?
It is actually mostly amlaki in it. Pardon?
Chyawanprash also? Along with
Chyawanprash also can be taken. Yeah, Chyawanprash also can be taken. That's also not a problem. But apart from that, all the rasayanas maximum are disease oriented, like targeting a problem.
What about that?
During the summer?
Amlaki and Harad, the three.
Trifala. It's called Trifala.
Yeah.
If you have problems with the eyes, I think there's a disturbance somewhere.
Somebody has to switch off as well.
Somebody please mute your phone, I guess. You know, it's a phone's disturbance. Yeah. Thank you.
So it's like when you are actually using Trifala, you have to add, it has been advised along with the usage of madhu and grita, that is honey and ghee, but not an equal quantity, so that it is like you are adding half spoon of ghee and one spoon of honey, and then you can intake. In such condition, it is a very effective medicine for the eyes.
And also, what about evening diet during Ayurveda? What is one expected to eat after 5?
Pardon?
In a dinner.
Could you also tell us a little bit about having wheat? Because these days, again, this whole thing about gluten and everything, and wheat is not good, use other atas. But from the north, we are just used to eating wheat all the time.
Now, let me tell you, this gluten problem and all comes only because your digestive pattern. It is not about the wheat. The wheat has been the same, and only that there has been hybrid varieties that is happening. Apart from that, it is our digestive pattern that has to be improved. So, as I still say, ghee and all were actually part of the preparation of rotis, right? Ghee, butter,
yes.
So all of these actually helped in aiding that snigdha content. You know, the body requires that oiliness also, and that oiliness was being targeted with all these materials. And let me tell you, like in North India, it is actually wheat that is most used. Yes. In South India, it is rice, because these are actually used only based on the climatic conditions. So I don't think we have to change from it.
Thank you.
Welcome.
So what is the evening diet you suggest, Ma, for a senior citizen?
Anything that you can take by 7 o'clock.
So it has to be fruits or anything carbohydrate, protein.
I'm against intake of fruits during that time because, you know, it kind of creates that acidity after some period of time. Most people have problems also, but let me tell you, some people feel fine also after taking fruits. So it varies. You cannot customize it, but it is best to go with some milk diet, like a little bit of porridge with milk or something like that, which is actually soothing in nature and not very spicy food, because that spicy food will actually create type of constipation problems can arise, and so that all you can avoid. And if you're taking roti, you can take the roti by 7 o'clock, making it earlier so that it is properly digested by the body.
Right. That's a good suggestion. A milk porridge is a very wise meal to, you know, close the day in the evening. Very wise suggestion.
Do not add sugar.
Doctor.
Coconut milk is actually, one medicine also that can be added as milk if you want to make it as a porridge. There you can add a little bit of pinch of salt if required.
Pinch of salt, you can add jaggery, a bit of jaggery too in the porridge.
Jaggery also.
With the coconut milk.
Yeah.
There's a question from
Doctor.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, actually, I feel my name is Anita. I feel low. Okay. Whole day, my energy level will not be that much high. And then I feel low whole day. So, what should I do, Doctor?
What is your age?
I'm 52.
Is it low physical illness or mental illness?
Physically.
Physically. Okay, what is your age?
I'm 52.
Then I think you are fit enough for undergoing a kind of mild purgation. It will be okay.
Mild?
Purgation. Slightly like you have a loose bowel habit, like you are intaking medicine and having some bowel removal. So what happens is your body will automatically get freshed up.
Okay. Great.
Like an enema.
Pardon?
Is it like an enema?
No. No enemas. No enema. It's just like you intake some medicine and then you have your loose bowels. So that the bowel clearance will happen, and fasting can also be a good thing. Let me tell you.
There is
fasting,
noise.
Fasting, yeah, somewhere it is creating a problem. Ms. Rama Mohan, it is like you can do fasting also. That's also one of the best ways.
Okay. Weekly once?
Yeah, that will be good. One day you can fast, not beyond that.
Okay. So that fasting, like total fasting or some fruits I can have?
I would advise when you're not used to it, it would be better juice fasting.
Juice fasting. Okay. Vegetable.
If you're feeling hungry, take some juice, but without added sugars.
Aha. Okay.
That would be good.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Hello.
Is it okay to have honey with the lemon juice in the morning?
That's fine. But this lemon juice, if you're regularly using it, some people can have problems of acidity. So not to be a regular practice.
Okay.
The honey will not be a problem, but lemon, not regular. Too much of acid you're directly intaking. No, so it's better not to have so much.
Hello, madam. I have sometimes a problem of sleep. I get to sleep immediately by 11:30 or so for 2-3 hours, and then I wake up. Then I find very difficulty in getting asleep. Or sometimes I don't get to sleep for first 2-3 hours, and then after 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, I get to sleep.
Actually, you will need
oil massage to the navel or something like that will help?
No. Actually, pattern of sleep has to be altered. So, you will need some medication.
Okay.
Not very much. Fine.
Okay. So you mentioned about the oil massage from the navel or
you try feet. Applying oil to the feet. That will be good.
Okay. So I apply oil to the feet and wash after 1 hour or so.
Yeah. After a week, you can try. You can see if they are not benefiting, then you can get back to us.
Okay. Any specific oil you mentioning?
Sesame oil, that would be the best.
Sesame oil. All right. Okay, fine. We have any other questions? Because
Roy wanted to ask.
Yes, ma'am. One thing I want to ask.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, can I ask? Please go.
Yeah, ma'am. You just told that trifla, if it is taken with 1/2 teaspoon ghee and 1 teaspoon honey, that is good for eyes, right?
Yeah.
Is this the correct way you
told me? The ratio of honey and ghee can vary. It is based on the people where we advise. Oh, okay. Yeah, the trifla can be added with ghee and honey and then intaken. That is becomes a rasayana. When it is taken with hot water, what happens is people take it like a laxative and it is more drying in nature. So when you're intaking it for a longer period of time, it becomes a problem.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. All right.
I think Mr. Kanchan.
Yes, Mr. Kanchan Roy, do you have any question? We heard that you had some doubts on it. Please go ahead. Unmute yourself and go ahead, sir.
I'm unmuted. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
During this pandemic, do you have any suggestion to for some precautionary food, solid or liquid?
Only thing that you are able to digest.
Thank you.
You should not have any day when you are not able to have a proper digestion. Your constipation, nothing should be there. Your sleep pattern should be proper. All that, if it is taken care, then you are disease free.
Thank you.